I'm calling this video How to Resize Images Using Lightroom CC or Creative Cloud. But the fact is, you don't really resize your images in Lightroom. You export copies of them and resize the copies. Your original files will not be affected by this process at all. So you can see that I'm in the library module to start with, and I have a bunch of images displayed, and I'm going to select a number of images for resizing. And I'm going to be sure to select some vertically oriented photographs and some horizontally oriented photographs. I'm holding down Command and clicking Images to show you that you can select non-contiguous images, images that aren't next to one another. On a PC, you would hold down Control while you click around. So I have a few images there, about 7 images. Once I have them selected, I'll come over here to the left panel and I'll select Export, and I'll click on that. Now, whenever you have a dialog box like this, it's always good to look at it from top to bottom and make sure you're doing everything you need to do. So you can see at the very top, it indicates that I am exporting 7 files. I have to select an export location. Where do I want these to go? Pay attention to this, or you might lose them. So I'm going to put them in the desktop, and then I'm going to create a subfolder on my desktop. I don't need to create the folder using my Finder in advance of doing this. I'll have Lightroom do it just by saying, put these in a subfolder, and I'll type in resize demo. So Lightroom's going to create that folder for me. I want to rename my files. Usually the file names assigned to your images by the camera don't make much sense. And there are many reasons you might want to rename them. You can also rename them when you're importing them into Lightroom. But for now, for this special purpose, I want to rename them upon export as something a little bit different. So I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to go into the custom drop-down menu and go all the way to the bottom where it says edit. Now I'm going to make a preset here. And in this case, I'm going to choose to name these files last name, underscore, first name, underscore, and then a series of sequence numbers. So since my name is John Doe, I'm going to put it in Doe, and underscore by holding down Shift and hitting the dash, John, another underscore. And now I'm going to insert a sequence numbering system using the sequence and date option here on the file name template editor. And if I hold this down, it's a drop down, and I can choose how many digits I want this to be. And I'm going to choose 2 digits. And when I click, or when I let go, it should pop up. Sometimes it pops up right in the window. Maybe it's because I didn't have that selected. Well, I can also click on insert and it pops up in this window. Now, once it's there, this is my indication that every file is going to have the words John Doe and then a different sequence number. The first one's going to be Doe underscore John 01. And they'll number all the way through, in this case, 07. Now, if I want to reuse that file renaming system, I'll just come up to this preset menu, and I'll save the current setting as a new preset, so I don't have to rebuild it. And I'll just call it last name, first name, and I'll say done. Okay, file settings is where we determine whether we want JPEG files or TIFF files or PSD files. You know, for the web or for emailing or Facebook or something, JPEG is the way to go. The color space is fine. And here I want to resize these. So I'm going to take that out for now. If I don't select resize to fit, the system will not resize my images and they'll be huge. So there are many choices in this drop-down menu about how to determine what the width and the height are. The one I always use is long edge. I just want to know what the longest edge on my file is going to be. So if I choose long edge, and then I type a value in pixels, I can choose inches too, but I'm going to work in pixels. And I'm going to put 2,000 pixels in there. So if I have a square image, it will be resized to exactly 2,000 by 2,000 pixels. But if I have an image that's longer or that's taller than it is wide, it'll be 2,000 pixels tall. If the image is wider than it is tall, it will be 2000 pixels wide, and the system will not change the aspect ratio or distort your images in any way. 2000 is a fairly large file, but that's what I want. You can change that to what you want for your purposes, but 2000 is the size I'm choosing. I don't sharpen when I export. I sharpen in the develop module usually. I don't watermark. I keep metadata turned on. I include the metadata upon export, so all that camera information will be attached to my JPEG file. You can select to open these files in Photoshop after they're exported, or another application, or show them to you in the Finder, or anything like that. I'm just going to say do nothing for now and click export. Once I do, you can see there's a progress bar at the top here saying export 7 files, and it won't take very long to do. I can already see that there's a folder that's been created on my desktop called Resize Demo. And now that that's finished, I will open that folder and we'll take a look in it. And you can see it's John Doe 01 through John Doe 07. And this vertical is 2000 pixels high, and the horizontals are 2000 pixels wide. So that's all there is to resizing your images using Lightroom CC. Thanks very much.